Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel, and hi if you're new here watching. My name's Hollie. Today I'm actually going to be creating a nice smoky eye. I did do a poll on Instagram and I asked everyone if they'd rather me do a classic smoky eye or a Christmas kind of glitzy smoky eye, and everyone obviously went for the Christmas one, which I'm so happy about. So I'm going to zoom you in and do a step-by-step tutorial, so make sure you keep watching. If you're wondering why I look a bit like a drowned rat with wet hair, it's because I have been swimming and I was too excited to do this look, so I was like, I'm just gonna film it with wet hair. It's fine, doesn't matter. If I start sweating, it's because it's really hot at the moment and I've had to close the windows because it's too loud, so God help me. Okay, so I've zoomed in loads. I'm here. Let me know if it's better for you guys, just so that then you can see a bit clearer. As you can tell, these aren't my natural eyebrows. I've just done my eyebrows off camera. I'm gonna go straight in with the look. So for this smoky look, I'm gonna use my Cocoa Blend Zoeva palette. The first shade I'm gonna go in with is the Freshly Toasted shade. I'm gonna take that on my BH Cosmetics brush, so it's a little bit more dense, and pack that on in my crease. I thought I'd do a smoky look just cause it's Christmas time. Gotta be a bit dramatic over Christmas, you know. I never wear smoky eyes when I go out, but maybe I should start doing it. So I'm just really packing on this shade in my crease. I'm going to pull it out a little bit. So the key to a smoky eye, especially if you're doing like a black smoky eye, is to blend, like blend until your arm is about to drop off. I'm really packing on this colour, so I'm just doing it in stages. I'm not going in with loads and loads of product at first, so just build it up. It makes it a lot easier to blend out afterwards as well. And I want it to be quite dramatic, so I'm going to make sure I pull it out a little bit. Can't really have a subtle smoky eye, can you, for Christmas? Like, if you're going to do a smoky eye, do a smoky eye, girl. So now I've got that colour packed on loads in my crease, I'm going to take a clean green. Don't worry, it's not actually got green on it, it's just stained, so yeah. And I'm just going to do tiny circular motions. Don't press too hard when you're doing this, because you've got to imagine the shadow's just on the surface of your skin, so you don't need to press really hard, you just want to be able to control it and just kind of disperse the product along the edges. And you can go backwards and forwards, or you can do like just little circular motions. Sometimes I find the circular motions a little bit easier. Make sure you blend out your inner corner as well. Now I've kind of blended out that harsh line, you can see the shadows kind of dispersed around this area here. So I'm going to go back in with the same brush that I've just used, with the colour that I've just used as well, really lightly, and then just kind of run it along. You can do like circular motions again. So I've just used Freshly Toasted and I've blended it all out. Once you're happy with that, you're going to go in with a black shade. And I'm using the shade Beans Are White. I'm going to take that on my really dense brush. I wouldn't really suggest doing your face makeup before doing a smoky eye, because if you get fallout, then you're absolutely, you're going to regret it. So I'm going to pop this on my outer corner. This is the scary bit, using the black. And right in my crease. You don't want to use a fluffy brush yet for this, because you just want to control where you're placing the product first. So I'm going to make sure I pack on quite a bit on the outer corner. And just bring it in softly on my inner corner and throughout that crease. You want to make sure you really kind of press it into the skin, just that when you apply more product on top, it doesn't just kind of flake off when you blend it. And I'm going to pack that on the lid. Don't worry about this inner corner here. That's where the exciting part comes. I honestly don't know how our eyelids perk with this. Sometimes I feel like mine's gonna drop off after YouTube tutorials and just like everything but the eyeballs. Okay, so as you can see, I've packed on the black in my crease. I've brought it down as well on the outer area of my lid and the corner. This part here, I'm gonna use like a metallic kind of shadow, so don't worry too much about that bit. I'm gonna take the fluffy brush that I used to blend out my first shade. It's still got a bit of product left over, you don't need to add any more. And what I'm gonna do is really gently, like before, little circular motions, just kind of blend out that black into the brown. So you can see that line kind of disappearing already. Yeah, when it's blended, it's a happy day. Okay, so this shade that I've just used here, I'm pretty sure it's a black, but I feel like it's kind of like a, I don't know. I've got another black that I'm gonna use just to deepen it up. If you do have this palette, then just go back in with the same shade. I don't know if you can tell between the two, but there's this black and then this one here. It's kind of a bit more like a cocoa bean. I don't know. Maybe that's why it's called Beans Are White. Actually, no, because I want this look to be quite dramatic, I'm going to go in with that darker black that I've got, and I'm going to go over the top of that other dark shade that I used just before. This is a bit more of a true black. It doesn't matter if it goes on your inner corner, don't worry about that. And then I'm going to use my fluffy brush again, and exactly the same as before, just disperse that product. Okay, so I've blended to my heart's content and it's looking nice and gradient now. So the shade that I'm gonna use is from the Zoeva palette again. I actually haven't used it on my lid yet, but I keep swatching it and it's going down, so I need to actually use it. Because I want this look to be quite soft and just blown out, I'm not gonna do a half cut crease or anything like that. Shock. So I'm gonna place the shade on my finger, just cause sometimes with the shimmery metallic-y shadows, they actually perform better when you place them on your inner corner of your finger. So I'm going to take the shade Pure Ganache. So now I've placed that shadow on my inner corner and the beginning of my crease, I'm going to go in with my Foil Play Cream Shadow by NYX, and I'm going to place it on top. After that, and you're happy with it, you're going to blend out that line that you've created and go in with that black. I'm just gonna pack it on again first, and then use my really fluffy blending brush really gently along that harsh line. Ooh, it's so hot. I'm literally melting in here, oh my God. So initially I used Pure Ganache, and that was just for the base of my glitter, and I used my finger just so that then the edges aren't too harsh. And then I went in with my Foil Play Cream Shadow, just to add a bit more sparkle on top, and I used the brush just so I could be a bit more detailed with it. Okay, I'm gonna line my lash line when I can find my eyeliner. I look very crazy right now. Okay, so I've just gone off camera and done my base makeup and the other eye. Don't freak out, this is not the look I'm going for. I've just baked underneath my eyes, just because when I do my lower lash line, I don't want to get any fallout and not be able to wipe it away. So for my lower lash line, I'm going to use the same colours that I used on my lid. The first one I'm going to go in with is Freshly Toasted, and I'm going to take that on the Fluffy Blending... Fluffy... Help me!
Fluffy blending brush.
Okay, I'm gonna smoke this out quite a lot, so I'm gonna take it further down than what I normally do. I'm just gonna run that along my lower lash line. Make sure you connect it to the outer corner as well. This is such a natural look, I love it. So next I'm gonna go in with Beans Are White, which is in my Zoeva palette. And I take that on a more dense brush. I'm gonna bring it a lot closer to my lash line. I make more of an effort for my videos than I do in real life. Like, don't be fooled. And then I'm gonna take this really tiny detailed brush and go in with the darkest shade that I used earlier, and then really bring that right up close to my waterline. So I've done both eyes on my lower lash line and they're looking nice and dramatic. You don't have to make it this blown out, but I just thought, if I'm gonna do a smoky eye, I need to do a smoky eye. So I'm gonna highlight my inner corners and use the e.l.f. Baked highlighter. This is the duo one, but I'm just gonna tap into this shade here with a fluffy brush and just run it along my inner corner. And I'm gonna use a small dense brush just on my brow bone. I've literally gone so overboard with this highlight that I look like I'm sweating and I love it. This is a finished look, I hope you like it. I just literally put some bronzer on and some lip gloss. One thing I will say is the lashes that I've got on, they're really natural, so they're not very dramatic, which is fine, but if you want it to be even more dramatic and intense, then get some like massive lashes. and just whack them on, really. If you made it all the way through the video, then thank you so much for watching. It means a lot. And if you have any ideas or looks that you'd like to see on my channel, then just comment down below. If you enjoyed my video, then please give it a like. It would mean so much to me. And subscribe if you'd like to see any more videos. If you're someone who doesn't really wear a smoky look, then I would definitely recommend doing it, because I never do and I love it, literally. My eyes are black and I love it. Thank you so much again, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.